Good morning, student. How are you? Now, in this session, we will study the classification of bearings. Let us have this chart, classification of bearings. Generally, broadly, the bearings are classified in two categories, sliding contact bearing and rolling contact bearing. Now, sliding contact bearings further classified as hydrodynamic bearing. And hydrostatic bearing. Now, hydrodynamic bearing and hydrostatic bearings both are further classified as guide bearing journal bearing. And thrust bearing. Now, journal bearing again classified as full journal bearings or partial journal bearings, foot step bearing, collar bearing. Now, rolling contact bearings broadly classified as ball bearing, and roller bearings. This is the classifications of bearings. Now let us see the classification of bearings in detail. According to the direction of force, here the direction of force or load is perpendicular to the axis of the shaft, and here the direction of load is in the direction of the axis of the shaft. Now, on the nature of relative motion between the surfaces, here the relative motion between the moving element is of sliding type, and here the relative motion between the moving elements is of rolling type. Now, classification on the basis of sliding contact bearing. The guide bearing, this is guide bearing and journal bearing. Now, in guide bearing, the motion is, this is the fist part, this is moving part that slides, and direction of load is downward. Now, this type of bearing is generally used in lathe to support the carriage. The bed serves as a bearing, and this is the carriage that moves along the horizontal direction, and this is the direction of load. So this is guide bearing. Now next is journal bearing. Journal bearing is classified in full journal bearing, partial journal bearing, fitted journal bearing. Now this is full journal bearing. This is the figure of full journal bearing, and this is the figure of partial journal bearing, and this is the figure of fitted journal bearing. Now, bearings are also classified on the mode of lubrication. Now, this is hydrodynamic lubrication and this is hydrostatic lubrication. Here, pump is used. Now, next is the classification of thrust bearing. This is pivot bearing and this is the figure of collar bearing. Now classification of rolling contact or on the basis of rolling element. Here ball is used as a rolling element and here roller is used as a rolling element. This is the outer race, this is the cage and this is the inner race. Here hole is provided for the insertion of the shaft. So now this is all about the classification of bearings. Thank you very much. We will meet in next session.